Greetings, brothers and sisters in Christ. This weekend we come to the 24th Sunday of Ordinary Time. The second reading is rich. I love these words of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die with the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. That great truth can change everything. My life is not about me. My life does not belong to me. It belongs to Jesus Christ, and it's about Jesus Christ, and so is yours. Before Jesus came, we did not know what death was. Death was the enemy. Since Jesus came and went into our humanity and into our suffering and into our dying, the Father raised him. Now, for the Christian, there is no death. There is life, and there is life eternal, if we belong to the Lord. So we have a great God who finds a way to bring us to be with God forever. That makes us less afraid of death, and rather we look forward to a time of passing when I can pass into the fullness of life with God. The gospel today is Matthew chapter 18, and Jesus continues to teach his disciples and us about the ways of God's reign. This is God's dream for the world. So Peter comes up to Jesus and asks him, very specifically, how many times must I forgive someone? And Peter's doing like what you and I want to do. Just tell us, Jesus, what to do, and I'll try to do it. And so Jesus listens to Peter, who says, should I forgive someone 7 times? Well, the prophet Amos told us you should forgive someone 3 times. So good old Peter is doubling it and adding one more just for good measure. So Peter thinks he's doing well by mentioning 7. The English translation that we hear says Jesus responds not 7 times, but 77 times. The actual Greek says 70 times 7 times. So if you're counting, that's 490 times we should forgive. So we know it's not about math, right? Jesus is teaching us that the reign of God is reconciliation again and again and again. We learn how to return evil with love. We return any kind of unforgiveness with forgiveness. Reconciliation is the key. If I don't forgive someone, the spiritual life is blocked in me. To make his point, Jesus tells a parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. This is a story about God and us. God wants to settle accounts with us in a good way. He calls in a man who owes a huge amount. The actual Greek says that he owes 10,000 talents. Well, 1 talent is 15 years of wages. So if you're into mathematics, this man owes 150,000 years of wages to the king. And he begs for mercy, and the king forgives him. Then the man turns around and fails to forgive the talents of someone who owed him much less than that. When we stand before God who has given us and forgiven us so much, why can't we just forgive this much?